Good morning. I greet you in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. A story is being told of an elderly couple who were driving on their way from their farm to town. And the wife said to her husband, "My dear, do you still remember when we first got married, how close we used to sit to each other in the little buggy on the way to the farm?" And he said, "Yes, my dear, I remember." And she said, "But my dear, what happened to us? Why do we sit so far apart now?" And he was silent for a moment, then said, "My dear, I'm still sitting exactly where I've always been, behind the steering wheel." Do you sometimes feel far away from God? As if He is miles away and you are praying to the ceiling, as if God cannot hear you? Do you sometimes feel that God has left you, or left us as a world? It seems like you are in good company, because all through the Bible there's passages where you just have to go to the Psalms and read how many times the man who was said to be God's friend, David, says that he feels that God is not hearing him. Jesus told the story, a parable of two sons. Two sons, one of which was called the lost son. You remember the story? The parable of the lost son, where he squandered everything, all his inheritance that he has asked for before his dad even passed away, squandered it with reckless living, and then decided when he was hungry, maybe he should go back to his dad. And with his tail between his legs, he did. And then we read in Luke chapter 15 from verse 20. "So he got up and went back to his father. But while he was still a long way off, his father saw him and he was filled with compassion for him. He ran to his son, threw his arms around him and kissed him. The son said to him, 'Father, I have sinned against heaven and against you. I am no longer worthy to be called your son.' But the father said to his servants, 'Quick, bring the best robe and put it on him. Put a ring on his finger and sandals on his feet. Bring the fattened calf and kill it. Let's have a feast and celebrate. For this son of mine was dead, and he is alive again. He was lost, and he is found.' So they began to celebrate." And then we read that the older brother, who was responsible and never went anywhere, started grumbling. Because why does he not get a feast? And he's been the responsible one. He has stayed. He never went anywhere. And in verse 31, we read the father's words to the older brother. "My son," the father said, "you are always with me, and everything I have is yours. But we had to celebrate and be glad, because your brother was dead, and he is alive again. He was lost, and he is found." You see, God hasn't moved away. He's been there all along, like this father, who stayed in one place, stayed looking, watching, waiting for his son to return home. And so, if something happened in our lives, if we have lost our way and rebelliously went our own direction, we can always come home. We can go back and say to God, "Lord, I messed up. whether it's the first time or the so manyth time, Lord, I messed up. And God welcomes us back, like this father did. But some of us are more like the older brother, aren't we? We never really did anything particularly bad. And we've sort of done everything the right way. Yes, we sometimes think something or say something that we shouldn't have, but we're not really bad. And it feels unfair that God throws open his arms to the really rebellious children, those who have gotten involved with drugs, the real sinners in our eyes. But then God says, my child, what I have is yours. It's always been yours. And so even for us, there's reason to celebrate. Even when we feel that God is not hearing, he's still there. He's been there all along. And all we had to do was say, Father, I need that connection today. It is time for us to go back home. Go back to the Father's arms. It is time for us to reach out to him, even if we feel that we've always still been with God, but just it's not the same. Perhaps it's time for us to just change our perspective and realize that if there's distance, it's not from God. The distance is from us. Let us draw near to God as he draws near to us. God has not moved. Let us pray. Father, you know our hearts. You know how many times we feel that you are distant from us. Help us to realize that those feelings are just our feelings. And that sometimes it's just Satan's way of trying to convince us that you're not there. But help us to realize that you're always there for us, even if we messed up, because you love us and you've always loved us. Father, we pray that you will help us to be a little bit gracious with the people around us. And realize that in the same way that you throw your arms open for us when we mess up, that your arms are wide enough to embrace those we cannot. Help us to reach out to you and to others in love. We pray this in Jesus' name. Amen. Have a blessed and safe week in his presence. Goodbye.
Draw me close to you. Never let me go. I lay it all down again to hear you say that I'm afraid. You are my desire. No one else will. Nothing else can take your place. To feel the warmth of your embrace. Help me find a way. Bring me back to you. Singing.